Exercise 4.4, question number 2. The second subdivision is sine inverse of minus 1 plus cos inverse of 1 by 2 plus cot inverse of 2. This one is not belongs to principal value. That is, does not change. This one answer, that's all. Cot inverse of 2. Okay. Next, cos inverse of minus 1. Minus 1. Cos theta minus 1. Cos theta 1 is going to pi by 2. That is called 90 degree. Next, cos inverse of 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means 60 degree. Cos theta is reached by 1 by 2, 60 degree. That is called pi by 3. So, the second subdivision we have to solve. Sin inverse of into minus 1 plus cos inverse of into 1 by 2 plus cot inverse of into 2. Okay. First, let us take this one. Sin inverse of, let us take the first term of the series. Sin inverse of minus 1 equal to, so this one sin inverse of minus 1 is equal to x, let us consider. So next one, minus 1 is going to sin x, which implies sin x is equal to minus 1. Okay, sin x is equal to minus 1. So minus 1 means minus sin pi by 2. Okay, next one, sin x equal to sin of into 1 by 2, that is pi by 2, minus pi by 2. Sin sin cancel, now x is equal to minus pi by 2, the first term completed. Next, let us take the cos inverse of, take cos inverse of 1 by 2, cos inverse of 1 by 2. This one let us consider y is equal to cos inverse of into 1 by 2. Next, cos y equal to 1 by 2. This one cos pi by 3. So y is equal to pi by 3. The first term x, the second term y. So therefore, the given statement sin inverse of minus 1 plus cos inverse of 1 by 2 plus cot inverse of 2. So that is equal to this one, minus pi by 2. Next plus pi by 3. Next plus cot inverse of 2. So that is equal to this one cross multiplication, minus 3 pi plus 2 pi whole divided by 6 plus cot inverse of into 2. So is equal to this one minus pi by 6 plus cot inverse of 2. So that is equal to cot inverse of 2 minus pi by 6. That's all the answer of second subdivision. That's all.